Places like Canary Wharf in the 19th century, cargoes from across the globe were unloaded because old Father Thames was the gateway from London to the British Empire that it controlled. And those burly dockers needed substantial food. But in the polluted river, the only life that could survive was the slippery eel.
We are, yes.
How lovely to see you. Michael. I'm Michael.
My name's Kane. This is my brother Jeff.
Nice to meet you, Michael.
Great to see you, Jeff. Wow. Kane, I noticed over the door it says Goddard's 1890.
Yep, correct.
So, a family business since then?
Yeah, it is. So, myself and my brother, five generations. So, go right back to my great-grandfather, Alfred Goddard, who started our first pie shop in Evelyn Street in Deptford. The one thing that's always stayed fairly constant is traditional pie mash and liquor. And the liquor being the eel stock, which is what we all know about.
Do you still use eels?
We do jellied eels, which is quite traditional across London. And we do stewed eels. Now, the original way to have your pie mash was pie mash and eels. People say pie mash and eels, and you knew it was going to be a hot portion of eels on the plate. And as they say, it's kind of the original surf and turf. It's your meat, fish, stodgy potato, and liquor on top. And this was when eels were actually quite affordable. Today, eels are really expensive, even more so than smoked salmon. It's crazy. But we do it because it's very traditional, very, very traditional.
So do you enjoy the eel yourself?
I do, yeah. I'm not so keen on the jellied, funny enough. I like stewed eels, definitely. Hot eels is lovely.
I've recently encountered eels, and they are great big burly creatures, aren't they? Pretty thick.
People get put off because they think of it as a snake. But actually, it's actually quite a nice, delicate white fish. This is London grub. This is traditional London food. This is the heartthrob of London. It's not fish and chips, and it's not all the other types of food. Fish and chips is more, a seaside event. This is what London was built on. The dock workers, all the hard working men along the River Thames on both sides, north and south, they would eat pies. They would eat pies and eat stodgy mash, and it was a really good, hearty, cheap meal for them.
Back in the 19th century, what were the pies made of?
The pies were a mixture of meat, actually, originally. You would have a bit of mutton and also a bit of beef. Depending on the period, depend on what they could put in them, to be honest. I think meat got quite scarce for a period of time in kind of the late Victorian period. And so they substituted it sometimes with other types of meat. A lot of the meat back then would not have been, as I would say, edible. It was quite rancid. And what they used to do to get over this problem is, which is very traditional, that, which is a chili vinegar, used to go on to the dinner, and it used to take away the bitterness of the meat. And so that's kind of how that's evolved over the last 120, 130 years. That went on your dinner. And so it's obviously stood the test of time. I'm pleased to say the meat today is far better.
So I suppose your future was pretty much set out when you were born. People talk about a glass ceiling, but do you feel you've had a pie crust on your life?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. I think it has been. There's always this underlying pressure to take on what your forefathers have done and keep the tradition going. Me and my brother, when we were young boys, we were in helping my mum and dad. So I might have been...
When you were young boys?
Yeah, young boys. When we were 7, 8 years old, I would have been in the restaurant and I would have been clearing the tables. And back in those days, people would give you like a little 10p tip, 20p tip. And it was great. I loved it. You've got to have a passion. If you're not passionate about what you do, then you're in the wrong business.
I am salivating. Any chance of a pie?
Here comes the food of the gods here. Right, so you've got the most traditional thing, which is the pie... mash and eels, all on one plate. Spoon and fork because you don't eat it with a knife. Okay, and then you've got your jellied eels there.
My goodness.
So just be careful, don't eat it whole because there's a bone in each piece. We don't want you choking to death.
Okay? All right, Jeff, thank you very much.
Enjoy.
Indeed. Thank you.
Before you go tucking in, the most important thing, this is what most people do, they use the fork and the spoon, they'll break open the top of the pie a little bit, and then they'll put on the chili vinegar and a dash of pepper as well. And that is exactly as you should have it. Dig in. Now, going to be interested to see what you think.
Oh, the pie is great. Because that really lifts it, actually.
It's lovely.
I didn't think the pie was going to be any kind of challenge to me. But the eels is another matter.
So in the old days, you put the whole piece of eel in your mouth,
mm-hmm.
and then you either pulled a bone out, and in the old days we used to chuck them on the floor. This was when we had sawdust on the floor, and we used to, at the end of the day, sweep it all up and dispose of it. But that was the old school. Today, we like to do things a little bit more sedately.
Mm.
Just put the bone on the end of your plate.
Yeah. Actually, I quite like that. It's a meaty old fish, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Well, liquor has taken me by surprise a bit, because it's quite green.
Yep.
So what goes into this liquor?
Well, it's a very closely guarded secret,
mm-hmm.
One of which I would have to dispose of you if I told you. So
in the river?
In the river.
Yeah.
In the old days, it used to be made from the stock of the eels.
Mm-hmm.
So when we were selling huge volumes of eels, you would siphon out the eels and you're left with this lovely broth, which you would essentially flavour and season. And then they turned it into basically a parsley sauce. So that's why you got the green in there.
Okay.
So the parsley would be blitzed and that would go into the stock. Pie mash and liquor without the liquor, it's not traditional.
This is the trickiest bit for me, the jelly, because I'm not really very keen on jelly.
Yeah. Okay, so when they're cooking the eels, you get...
Okay.
Is that one you're not going to try again?
That's not brilliant for me. It's a matter of texture. I don't like the jelly texture very much.
Yeah, but the gelatine naturally comes from the bone of the eel as well. But they also do put in a little bit of natural gelatine in there to kind of thicken it up when they're cooking it.
Are you changing your menus? Are you in any way sort of moving with the times? Or?
Yeah, I think you'd be a fool not to. I mean, things have changed over the years anyway. A lot of people have always been under the idea that traditional pie houses only do pie mash and liquor. Well, that's not the case, because 130 years ago, we were selling fruit pies, meat, suet puddings, and traditional pies, of course. So what we've learned, certainly in the last 20, 30 years, you know, there's a lot more vegetarians out there. There's a lot more vegan people. There are a lot of people that don't like red meat. So you have to cater for everybody. So we will now do a variety of different pies.
I don't know what the doctors of the 19th century would think about your vegetarian pies, but are there limits? Are there traditions that must not be broken?
Pie mash and liquor will always be the staple food that we will sell. But what we won't do is diversify into doing burgers and chips and other things just because we can and because there's a market out there. It takes away the origins of what we're about, you know, the traditions of what we're about. So we will always sell pies, we will always sell mash, and we will always sell gravy or liquor. And that is the staple food in this business. We will not diversify away from that.
Kane, you are a man of principle.
Definitely. Thank you.